Progressive groups call on the Philippine Supreme Court to revisit its ruling allowing power distributor Meralco to impose staggered rate hikes. Bayan Muna, along with fellow Makabayan Bloc members, filed a motion for reconsideration Wednesday. The High Court earlier this month upheld the Energy Regulatory Commission's 2013 decision, approving the rate hike totaling 22.6 billion pesos. Meralco's request for a rate hike stemmed from the shutdown of the Malambaya operations and the scheduled maintenance of other power generation plants. But the petitioners argue the ERC hastily approved the request without due process and without taking into consideration the impact on consumers.
This is not just a question whether or not the ERC failed to exercise its vast powers as a regulator. Ang nakasalalay rito ay ang interest rin ng ating mamamayan na overburdened na at ngayon nga ay napipintong magpapasan sila ng dagdag pagtaas ng kuryente.
The United States and 17 allies agreed to work together to improve the global supply chain. That's after a two-day virtual supply chain ministerial forum hosted by America. Participants included Australia, Canada, and the European Union. In a joint statement, the nations vowed to engage businesses and labor groups to address the disruptions and bottlenecks in the global supply chain. Steps include increasing transparency of trade information, diversifying sources, and increasing the security of supply chains. Snarls in the supply chain began during the pandemic and have been made worse by Russia's war in Ukraine and stringent COVID-19 restrictions in China.
Meanwhile, more than 500 people have died in the heat wave engulfing Spain. That's according to the country's prime minister, who cited figures from the Health Research Institute. Spain has been gripped by a heat wave affecting much of Europe, which has pushed temperatures to as high as 45 degrees Celsius and sparked dozens of wildfires. The prime minister says more than 70,000 hectares have been burned. The World Meteorological Organization on Tuesday said the heat wave in Europe will continue to last at least until next week. COVID-19 infections in the Philippines continue to rise. On Wednesday, the country logged another 2,000 new cases. More than 700 of those were detected in Metro Manila. The health department also recorded hundreds of cases of Omicron subvariants, but majority of them have already been tagged as recovered. The DOH believes the uptick in infections has yet to peak.
We do not see na meron tayong plateauing or pagbagal sa ngayon ng pagtaas ng kaso. Actually, in our projections, we are seeing that by the end of July, mas tataas pa ang mga kaso natin. Baka hindi pa natin masang-ayunan yung sinasabi nilang magpipik na tayo ngayong linggo at bababa sa mga susunod na linggo.
Despite COVID cases hitting more than 2,000 per day, the DOH says all regions in the country remain at low-risk case classification while the healthcare utilization rate is still at 24%.
Lahat po ng mga rehiyon ay nananatiling may less than one case per 100,000 population na average daily attack rate maliban sa limang regions of the country. And this would be NCR, CAR, Region 3, Region 4A, and Region 6 na mayroong ADAR ranging from 1.56 to 5.8 cases per 100,000 population. Nananatiling mababa ang ating national admissions kung ikukumpara natin nung nag-umpisang tumaas ang ating mga kaso noong Mayo. Gayunpaman, nakakakita rin tayo ng unti-unting pagtaas sa mga admissions nitong nakaraang linggo.
The Health Department is set to launch a COVID booster drive next week amid the threat of more Omicron subvariants. The Pinas Lakas campaign aims to get 90% of senior citizens inoculated and 50% of the target population boosted within the Marcos administration's first 100 days. The DOH plans to set up vaccination sites in schools, public markets, workplaces, and intensify house-to-house jabbing. It's also coordinating with other agencies on a proposal to redefine fully vaccinated to include one booster dose.
Primarily, that's what we are thinking about. And hopefully, in the coming days, pag nag-convene na tayo ng IATF natin, mailagay na natin sa agenda, mapag-usapan, mapagkasunduan, at mairekomenda na uli sa ating presidente.